framework has given clear idea about how a software testing environment to be set up. Okay. In continuation of the previous class, let us start today's session with the requirement of software testing. Let's go to the slide. For all the topics we have covered in the previous class. So requirements for testing tools. Okay, the first requirement is no hard coding is in the test suite. As you know, the basic requirement, though it is expected a software tester need to have the basic knowledge about programming, it is not mandatory that all the software tester should have the knowledge on programming. Okay, keep all the variables separately in a file. Anyway, the environment will provide you the all the facilities, and you can keep the variables separate in a separate file, and source code need not be modified. Okay, what you are going to do is you are going to test the code, the source code which has been developed by someone, or you are not going to do any changes on after in the software. It is required to run the test for different values of variables. Okay, so you are, as a software tester, what you will do, you will take the source code and you will run the test with the help of different test variables. The person does not know the program to change the values and run the test source. Okay, so that is what I told anyone. Okay, even the tester without having any software, any programming knowledge, can test the software with the help of changing the variable. And the second requirement is test case and test suite expandability. Okay, so I used to insist even in the class that the generation of test cases, a generation of test suite is not static. Okay, it is a dynamic process, a never-ending process. We can expand the software testing test cases or test suites anytime. Okay, so adding a test case should not affect other test case. Okay, you must be very careful when you add a new test case or test suites. It should not affect the previous test cases generated and stored in the database. Now, adding a test case should not result in retesting the complete test suite. Okay, so when you add a test case in the set test suite, okay, you know the definition of test suite. It is the similar test cases. It consists of similar test cases. When you add a new test case in a test suite, okay, it should not affect the previous test cases. Adding a new test suite to the framework should not affect existing test suites. Similarly, when you add a test suite in the test frame, it should not affect the existing test suites. And the third requirement is reuse of code for different types of testing test cases. Okay, so reusability is an important phenomena in software development. We have to reuse all the components. So if you consider the login example, here the functionality of the product becomes test cases for different types of test. What normally basically we test the functionality of the software. Function that are required, more than one test case can be included in the library. Okay, we can maintain a library where you can keep the test cases or the functions that require more than one test cases. Okay, some only do what a test is expected to do. The test framework needs to take care of how, and so the framework which we have discussed in the previous class. Okay, this framework, somebody is coming to the class. I have to give acceptance. 1 minute. Okay. Kavya Tamil. Now, 28 students are in the class. Okay, kindly chat with your private group or subgroup and ask your students, encourage your students, encourage your friends to join with the session. So, the test framework will take care of. This is what the test framework, and the test framework will take care of how to execute the test cases. That is what is mentioned here. Test suite should only do what a test case is expected to do, The test framework needs to take care of how. The test programs need to be modular to encourage reuse of code. And the fourth requirement is automatic setup and cleanup. Okay, so we need to have the mechanism within the tool to set up automatic setup and automatic cleaning up of the things. Okay, we will see what. Object to be created or some portion of the product to be configured to meet prerequisites. Okay, so before starting it, some of we need to create some object or some a portion of the product to be configured. And each test program should have a separate setup program, and it will create necessary setup before executing the test cases. And cleanup program will undo the setup once after the execution. Okay, these are all the primary requirement, and it set up automatically and clean up the prerequisite, the objects which automatically created or set up once the testing is over. Independent test cases. Okay, so we have this slide and the next slide. We will see the dependency of the test cases. So even for a small example, we have to create a number of test cases. Okay, so you have to be very careful that while generating test cases, the test case should be independent, not only in design phase but also in the execution phase. Okay, each test case should be executed alone. Okay, and there should be the provision, the tool must give the provision for that, and there should not be any dependency between test cases. And the test engineer can select any test case at random. And there should be any dependency. There should not be any dependency between test cases. Okay, so so independent test cases. So some test cases are very independent, and some test cases are dependent to other cases. Okay, dependent test cases, independent test cases means the test case can run independently. Okay, the platform should give this what the requirement. The platform should provide the option for executing the test cases, independent test cases. Okay, and the test engineer can select any test case at random. And for dependency test cases, making a test case dependent on other makes it is necessary for a particular test case to be executed before or after a dependent test case is selected for execution. Okay, some test cases may depend on other test cases. Okay, because we need the previous test cases to be executed before executing this particular test cases, this dependent test cases. Okay, so that provision the testing tool must provide. A test tool or a framework should provide both the future for dependent test cases and future for independent test cases. Okay, I hope that you have understood the difference between dependency test case and Tenmoli is coming. Okay, dependency test case and non-dependency. Okay, can you able to follow me? Please give a respond through chat. Okay, thank you. I'm getting respond from Kavita, Karthik, Jayaraj, Balaji, Davidson, Samraj. Okay, thank you. Let's move. The framework should help to specify the dynamic dependency between insulating test cases during execution. Okay, so let's come in. Insulating test case. At the time of test case execution, there could be some events or interrupts or signals in the system that may affect the execution. Okay, so we cannot expect that everything will be okay all time. Okay, so best example is we never thought of this lockdown. Okay, so everything were going very smoothly and people were very busy, but the lockdown came and we are all inside the house. We are not able to move, we are not able to come to. But what is it? What is insulating is nothing but, so don't worry about your class, and we are conducting the class through online, we are giving assignments through online, and we are engaging you through with the help of technology. Similarly, when you execute when you execute a test case, during the execution time, some failure may occur. Okay, failure with respect to signal, failure with respect to the power cut. So anything, a technology, technical failure may come. So at that time, test case of execution, there could be some events or interrupts or signals in the system that may affect the execution. Hence, a framework should provide an option for users to block some of the events. Okay, it has to identify some of the events, some of the events will affect it. So wisely, what facility, what feature is required in the software testing environment is option in the framework to specify what events can affect the test suite and what should not. Okay, if the framework indicates you what will be, you can stop those execution. Okay, it is something like so if you are using single phase for your home, you cannot run all the appliances in the single time. Okay, you cannot put a mixie, you cannot put grinder, you cannot put a washing machine, you cannot put your water. Okay, one by one you have to do, since we are all doing it because we have three phase connection. Okay, if you have one phase connection, either one or two must be in the switched off mode. Okay, so similarly, while executing your test cases, insulating, so how a copper wire is insulated with the help of the plastic sheet, the normal wire, similarly we have to protect the execution of the test cases. The eighth requirement is coding standards and directory structure. So in order to help the new engineers to understand test suite fast, we have to maintain a directory and the coding standards. And incorporating the coding standard improves portability of the code. And the test framework forces the directory structure to enable multiple programmers to develop test suites in parallel. Okay, so people work from different areas for a same program. So test framework forces the directory structure to enable multiple programmers to develop such test suites in parallel. In the coming few slides, we are going to discuss about the selection of test cases, how the test cases will be selected. Okay, before that, let us recap the definition for test framework, test suite, and test program. Okay, let me start from the bottom. Okay, test program, the basic thing is test cases. You know, what is the test cases? Okay, so I can define test program from test cases. It is nothing but it is a collection of test cases. Test programs are nothing but collection of test cases. Test suites are nothing but multiple test case test programs, and framework is nothing but multiple test cases. Facility to select a particular test case or a set of test case and execute them. Okay, the provision must be provided by the tool in the software framework to select single test case or multiple test case to execute them. Selection need not be in order, and any combination should be allowed. Okay, I cannot force, I cannot expect that I will say, for example, I have 10 test cases in a test program. Okay, I cannot expect that I will execute the test cases one by one. Test case 1, test case 2, test case 3, test case 4. No, it is not like that. Okay, the example I have given here is test program, then 2, 4, 1, then 7 to 10. It means I will execute the test program 2, followed by test program 4, followed by test program 1, followed by test program 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, again, coming back to test program 2, while I'm executing test program 2, it means that all the test cases which are available in test program 2 will be executed. Okay. Then requirement 10 is random execution of test cases. Now let us see different selective mechanism, selection mechanism. Giving a set of test cases for expecting the test tool to select the test case is called random execution of test cases. Here, the framework or the tool must give the facility to the tester to select the test cases on random basis. Example 1 says that test program 251 is means all the test cases of test program 2 will be executed, followed by all the test cases of test program 1 will be executed, and all the test cases of test program 5 will be executed. Okay, from the example 2, what we are going to learn is all the test cases of test program 2, followed by all the test cases of test program 1, followed by all the test case 5, and the test program 2 again, test program 3. Okay, then parallel execution of test cases. Okay, now then the question is it possible, is it allowed to execute the test cases in a parallel way? Parallel execution simulates the behavior of several machines running the same test, and hence it is very useful for performance and loading test. Okay, so when you test the performance testing, or when you do your load testing, okay, what do you mean by performance testing? Okay, my software may work properly in one system. Okay, I have not developed this software for the single user. I have developed this software for multiple users. So what I have to do is I have to check while running this program. Say for example, the railway reservation system. Okay, railway reservation software have been developed for multiple user. They will use the software in the same time. Okay, so if the typical time is 11 o'clock, all the users throughout the world will hit the site by 11 o'clock. Okay, so how I check the performance before launching the software? I have to test it with, in a simulation way, or I have to do it. Okay, I have to run with a number of systems. Okay, so while doing this performance test and loading test, this requirement will come into picture, requirement of parallel execution of test cases. Okay, what does it mean, test program 1 inside 3? It means that test program, we are considering the test programs. I may have a number of test cases inside test program 1, but among them I'm taking only the third test cases. And how many places parallelly I'm testing it is 5. Okay, and I'm taking the test cases 3 from test program 1 and parallelly testing it 5 different machines. Okay, so that is what it is very clearly mentioned, instance 5. Okay, what does it mean, the second instance 5? So here five systems are executing the programs. Okay, the first, the second test cases, first test cases, and fifth test cases of test program 1, followed by all the test cases of test program 2, followed by all the test cases of test program 3. Okay, can you able to listen me, follow me, give your response please through the chat? Yes, very good, very good, superb. Okay, let's go to the class now. The next is looping the test cases. Okay, so reliability testing requires the test cases to be executed in a loop. Iteration loop is nothing but number of iteration a test cases to be executed. Time loop is nothing but executing test cases in a loop time, the specified time, till the specified time duration. Okay, here the software environment, software testing environment, or the tool must give the facility for looping the test cases. It means that either it can be iteration loop or it can be timed loop. What do you mean by iteration loop? Iteration loop says that I have to specify the number of times it is executed. Okay, and the time loop says that till the time duration, say for example 1 hour, 2 hour, 5 hours. Okay, let us see the example. Example 1 says the repeat loop 50. 50 means 50 times. Okay, what I am going to do is I am taking the test case, third test case from test program 1 and executing it 50 times. Okay, so the example 2 says that 5 hours repeatedly Okay, I have set the loop in such a way that the test program, the test cases of test case 2, test case 1, followed by test case 5 of test program 1, followed by all the test cases of test program 2, followed by all test cases of test program 3 must be tested or executed continuously for 5 hours. Okay, 5 hours continuously I got executed things. Okay, hope it is very clear. So it is reliability testing. Reliability testing requires the test cases to be executed in a loop. Okay, the previous one we have seen for performance test and load test. Here we are seeing the reliability test. So the first example says that test case 3, the third test case of which we have taken from test program 1, must be executed 50 times. Okay, it is an example for this iteration loop. And the second example is for the timed loop. The timed loop, it says that 5 hours continuously I'm executing the following test cases. The second test cases, first test cases, and fifth test cases of test program 1, followed by all test cases of test program 2, followed by all test cases of test program 3. And the requirement 13, grouping of testing scenario. Okay, so now I can group it, this parallel, I can group the random or the parallel or looping and create a scenario. Okay, this is what the scenario. Group scenarios allow the selected test cases to be executed in order random in a loop at the same time. So here the scenario is test program 1, test program 2, test program 3 and 2. Okay, the group scenario I set in such a way that I am taking the scenario 1. Scenario 1 is this one 10 times and repeating it, and it is executed parallelly in two missions. Okay, that is what grouping of test scenario. For set test scenario, you have to derive the scenario first and you have to give the group scenario condition here. Okay, 10 times and in parallelly I am executing in two different missions. Requirement 4, the test case execution based on previous result. Okay, so here the regression test requires that the test cases be selected based on previous result. Okay, what do you mean by regression testing? From the word regression, we can say continuously, we keep on testing it. Okay, so the common scenario, when we will go for this regression test, rerun all test cases which are executed previously. Okay, sometimes during the regression test, we may consider all the test cases for execution. Sometimes resume the test cases from where they were stopped the previous time. Okay, sometimes we will take, say for example, I assume that I have 100 test cases and I have executed 50 executed and came to conclusion that it is passed, test is passed. So when you go for regression testing, what I can do is I can leave all the 50 test cases which I have executed earlier. I can start from 51 test cases. Okay, rerun only failed or not run test cases. Okay, so sometimes during the regression test, what we will do is already we have executed and failed test cases are there. Okay, so we are taking, we can take those test cases. Similarly, we can collect, we can take the test cases which we have not put into execution. And executed all test cases that were executed on time. A particular time, we can fix a time that execute all test cases that were executed on the particular. We are taking all the test cases which has been executed on the particular day. Okay, these are all some of the common scenario for regression testing. Why we are studying this? The software testing tool must provide the facility for satisfying or to perform the regression test. And the 15th requirement is remote execution of test cases. Okay, test console or test monitor. So here, I told you, it will, we can perform the test on various missions, various systems in different geographical location. Okay, so you have to be very careful of who will monitor it. So that we need a test console or test monitor. So this is the central mechanism that allocates test to multiple missions and coordinates the execution and result. Okay, assume that I'm taking 50 different system for execution, and this test console or the test monitor will take care of allocating the resources to different monitor different systems and coordinating with the test execution and collecting the results. Okay, so we need a test console or test monitor. And the another requirement for framework to execute or stop the test suit on any mission. Okay, so the test execute or test monitor test console can execute, not only executing, can stop even it on while running the while executing the test cases in some missions. The test results or logs can be collected from the test console. Okay, so normally the test results and logs are nothing but when it started the execution and what are the variables has been considered for execution, and when the execution was stopped, and what are the results. Okay, those things will be collected from the individual missions by the test console. Okay, the progress of testing can be found from the test console. Okay, we can see, we can monitor, we can observe the performance of the test, how it is going on with the help of the test console. Finally the automatic archival of a test case. Okay, so you can archive it. Okay, automatic archival of test cases. Test cases are repeated on the basis of previous results. Okay, so the archival of test case must include what configuration variable were used. Okay, so the basic thing is while executing the test cases we need variables. Okay, so what you are going to say, what you are going to archive is the configuration, the variables which we have used, and the what scenario we have used for the particular execution of test cases, and what programs were executed and from what path. Okay, this information must be archived. Why I'm saying here is the software testing tool must provide this kind of facility. That is what we are studying it under the requirement. Okay, and the report scheme is should include when the framework or scenario or test suite or test program and each test case was started and completed. Okay, this we have seen the components in the architecture. Okay, the result of each test cases and log messages when the operation was invoked, the values for variables when the operation was completed, and category of events and log of events, then audit report. Okay, so the audit report, we can generate the report on daily basis, we can generate report on weekly basis, we can generate report on monthly basis. Okay, the requirement software tool must provide this reporting scheme facility. And I think we are almost reaching the end of this presentation. The final, the 18th requirement is independent of language. The framework should be independent of programming language. We cannot say that this framework will only Java background. If this framework will only applicable for some specific language, you cannot say the framework, the software testing tool which we have developed should support all the programming background. Provide a choice of programming languages, scripts, and other combination. Have exported interfaces to support all popular standard language, and so you have to keep your mind while developing your automatic software testing tool. And the final requirement is portability to different platforms. The framework and its interface should be supported on various platforms. Okay, so the it's a plugin type. Okay, you can integrate with the already developed software. So the framework and its interfaces should be supported on various platforms. Portability to different platform is a basic requirement of testing tool or test suits. The language or script used in the test suit should be selected carefully so that it run on different platforms. So you have to be very careful on the languages and script used in the set suit should be selected carefully. The language and script written for the set test suit should not contain platform specific calls. If you have any platform specific call, then the portability is a question mark. This is what the last requirement. So we have seen today the 19 requirements for the software testing tool. We have seen it is under the topic of requirement of software testing tool, and we have studied of in continuation of the design and architecture of the automation. Okay, so the basic requirement, the first requirement is no hard coding in the test suite. Second requirement is test suite or test case or test suite expandability. And the third one is reuse of code for different types of testing and test cases. The fourth requirement was automatic setup and cleanup, independent test cases, test case dependency, insulating test cases during execution, coding standards and directory structure. Then selective execution of test cases, random execution of test cases, parallel execution of test cases, looping the test cases, grouping of test scenario, test case execution based on previous results, then regression test, sorry, test case execution based on previous result, remote execution of test cases, automatic archival of test data, report scheme, independent of language, portability to different platforms. Okay, so we have seen 19 requirement for the software tools. Okay, so I hope around 30 students have joined for today's section. Please be online. I will take a snap. Can anyone can you summarize this, what you have studied today? Anyone of you can you summarize by seeing the PPT also? You can. Yesterday, I have posted the PPT in the Google Classroom. I have observed that some of the students are not joined in the Google Classroom. I want to tell you one thing, that this Google Meet facility we have integrated in the Google Classroom. Okay, where if you go to Google Classroom, easily you can come to. Okay, so if you want, I can show the demo how to join in the Google Group, sorry, Google Classroom, if it is required. I will show you the demo. Okay, kindly join. Otherwise, I ask your friends, those who have not joined, to join, and we can do a lot of things in the inside the Google Classroom. Can anyone of you summarize what we have seen so far? Or you can chat. You can send your feedback in the chat. I'll be happy if somebody summarize it. You can see your PPT and talk. Can anyone summarize? Don't leave the meeting for a few minutes. Who is here? Do you like to present? Yes or no? Send your feedback in chat otherwise. Feedback? You like this session? Okay. Hariharan, yes sir. Good sir. Yes sir, session was useful. Nice sir. Okay, let me take a snap. Okay, thank you so much for being with us. I'm not able to see anyone. If okay, thank you so much. Would you like to ask anything?